But I still think there's got to be this situation in the West and that situation in the East where the unspoken is spoken. And here it's, I don't know what it is. There's just too much confusion between masculinity and femininity. It's just completely distorted. No one's in what they're going to be. So I think that place is here, they know what they are, and the unspoken spoken. Here, I don't think anybody knows what they are. I really don't.
Do you think it's Christian?
Probably. Christian essentialism, all that shit, for sure. It's so, I really believe what you were saying before when you were saying, oh, people say they're not that or this, but it's so ingrained that, I mean, even yoga itself, that's all that ascensionistic behavior about spiritual and being above and being one. That was one neat thing about the workshop. Michael Mead talked about spirit and all that. That's the one. That's rising up into the sky. And spirit is one, but we're all one and it's all spiritual. He's saying it's a bad thing. It's a good thing. I mean, you got to have it. We got to balance it with soul. And soul is diversity and ugliness and speak. So probably what's going on is you've got the West and we're all spiritual and all this and we're wearing the right clothes because we're going to yoga and we're all spiritual. And then you go to the East, it's like, fuck, whatever.
No
like,
Lululemon.
Fuck, no Lululemon. Yeah, fuck, yeah, sure. Okay, great. There's soul happening because they're speaking the unspoken. It's right there. And we don't want to look at it because, I don't know. Christian essentialist, and then there's this place in the middle, and I think the key when you're getting to it is spontaneity. There's a spontaneity, like the other, like yesterday, I went into Shell Gas to gas up, and here's this woman, I don't know, probably 45 or whatever, but attractive, and she's, and whatever, she's just so spontaneous, and she goes, I can read minds, and I, right there, I just want to say, see if you can read mind right. That's all I wanted to do. So if you think that you're the one stepping to my right, I'm a fine-tuned supersonic speed machine. Bubbly and light, and it was like, wow, this woman's alive, finally. Somebody who's not like, you know, you look at them like, oh, you know, that whole attitude of like, oh, don't look at me, look at me, don't look at me, look at me. That bullshit, that, you know. And she was, and but was right there was, see if you can read my mind now. And it came up, and I stopped it. And that's the line. That's something on the opposite stopped me. And that's the third. Speak that. Speak that. Speak it. That seems to be. And I think that's where the dream work is. Like when I'm working with the dream work, that's where those things start coming alive. It's because you cannot censor that stuff that comes from down there, right? You can't censor it. It's coming up, and then you go, well, you know, that's probably my blah, and there it is. And then you get more spontaneous as the work develops. Mm. And then that's where the fun is. I love it when it comes in because it's reckless, you know? And then all of a sudden, you got this recklessness and women want to be around it. I don't know what it is. They love that reckless It's not the nice guy, it's not the friendly guy.
You're kind of riding between the two.
What we get angry at is the, what I get angry at, and it, there's nothing wrong with it. Just, it's just like any woman who probably, you know, someone fucks them and it's just for sex, and they're, but they're saying something else. It's the same thing, you know? Fucking, we didn't learn this shit from nowhere. We've been through a lot of stuff. We've learned it. We read books. I'm not out making money, you know? I'm putting my energy into other things. And then they come and they want that fucking gold. Well, get that gold from your fucking boyfriend. If your boyfriend's not doing it, then why are you fucking hanging out with him? For security reasons? Get drinks, feel you? You feel you.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. You put the time in learning these things. This is our path. We care about it. So they want the fucking gold. Well, come on, let's do some of the fucking work. Let's get in trouble together. You really want to learn this shit? Let's get in trouble together. Let's find out what's happening.
No. Interesting.
Your friend. Okay, fine. Like, there's this, I never liked it. But I read this story where Jack Nicholson, some beautiful woman said, "Do you want to dance?" And he went, "Wrong adverb." No, that's just good old fucking honesty.
Yeah.
You know? And I don't know, this weekend when I was in California, the last weekend there when I was hanging out with those gals, I mean, it was fun. Because I was totally spontaneous and honest. Because we were going for a bite to eat. And they go, "Where do you want to sit?" And I said, "Well, to be honest with you, I'd like to sit on a patio so I can look at all the titties go by. Because I don't have titties in Banff. It's too cold." And they just loved it. Okay, sure, right here, I'll sit.